Our first presenter is Brian Murphy. Professor Murphy obtained his BS and MS degrees in organic chemistry from the University of Massachusetts, Dartmouth. He then obtained his PhD in chemistry at Virginia Tech and gained 2 years of training in marine microbiology and chemistry at the Scripps Institution of Oceanography at the University of California, San Diego. In 2010, he joined the Department of Medicinal Chemistry and Pharmacognosy at UIC. Dr. Murphy was the recipient of the American Society of Pharmacognosy's D. John Faulkner Award and is a Hans W. Voltek Scholar at UIC. His lab work has been featured by NPR, Science Daily, and the Toronto Star, among other publications.
I grew up loving the ocean, and when I attended college, I studied the chemistry of living organisms. And here at UIC, I'm able to combine these passions. So the focus of my laboratory is to explore the world's oceans and collect all the bacteria that live there. And we're going to use the chemical weapons that these bacteria produce to fight infectious diseases. Now, bacteria have been fighting each other with chemical weapons for millions of years now, and we're simply trying to harness this power. We spent decades exploring the land for antibiotics, and we've had some amazing successes. But antibiotic resistance is increasing faster than the rate of discovery of new drugs. So we're headed back to this post-antibiotic era, where our average lifespan will be considerably shorter. Now, the ocean is about 70% of our planet's surface, and it's almost entirely unexplored. And we're hoping that it can provide medicines that we can use to fight drug resistance. And we have an amazing team of UIC researchers supporting us here. So the diseases that we focus on are tuberculosis, led by Dr. Scott Fransblau, viral infections, led by Dr. Legion Rong, and ovarian cancer, led by Dr. Joanna Burdett. Now, these collaborators really drive the biology of our projects, and they allow us to chase potential drug leads from the bacteria that we collect. So we've set up collaborations with several international scientists, including Dr. Cecilia Amarsatir from the University of Iceland. Now, for a couple of years, our team drove around the perimeter of this volcanic island, and we used scuba diving to collect sediment, sponge, and other samples from which we can isolate bacteria. And although sometimes incredibly beautiful, these collections are very challenging. Now, most of the water that we're in is below freezing, and we need special gear just to dive there. But then there are other sites that have water from the Earth's crust that's literally gushing out of chimneys that are thousands of years old. But it's precisely these unique conditions that allow for a wealth of microbial biodiversity to grow within. And we think that with this diversity are new types of molecules that can be used as drugs. This is one of the next frontiers in the discovery of new medicines. But we can't always use scuba to access this biodiversity. In one case, we commandeered this Icelandic Coast Guard vessel just to perform deep ocean sampling, and we collected sediment from upwards to about 1,000 feet or so. And we used a mechanical arm that basically drops a trap, and it scoops up sediment right from the ocean bottom. Now, all of the samples that we collect in these trips, they're processed in a mobile lab that we've had to set up everywhere from seedy hotel rooms to swaying ships in 13-foot seas. And in the coming years, what we do is we work together to build libraries of bacteria that we can jointly use in order to fight disease. Now, in total, from our Icelandic samples, we've amassed a library of about 500 Iceland bacterial strains whose small molecules have been tested against the aforementioned diseases. And students in our labs are currently discovering molecules that show activity against TB, HIV, flu, Marburg, and other viruses, and ovarian cancer. Now, in addition to our Iceland collaboration, we share a collaboration with the Vietnam Academy of Science and Technology in both Hanoi and Nha Trang, Vietnam. And the purpose of this collaboration is not only to discover medicines from Vietnam's coast, but it's also to train young scientists and set up a self-sustaining drug discovery and conservation program there. Now, the reasons that we forged this collaboration are twofold. First, Vietnam has a large burden of TB and HIV, and we here at UIC have a contingency of researchers who work on these diseases. Secondly, the biodiversity in Vietnam, just like in Iceland, it's relatively unexplored. And we can use our discovery efforts to encourage conservation and combat coral reef destruction and overfishing practices. So for a few years, we've been transferring technologies overseas, and we've even hosted a student, Kuyen Vu, from Hanoi, who was tasked with shadowing our scientists in creating bilingual video protocols that she can bring back to her institution in order to train others. Now, she helped build a large library of bacteria from the East Sea. And we've screened this library, and as of today, we have several lead strains that show promising activity against both TB and HIV. And we've already co-published one of these studies with our Vietnamese colleagues, and there are several more in the queue as we speak. This project is really dear to us. There's been decades of negativity between our countries, and we found an opportunity here to build rather than to destroy. And we're continually building this trust and partnership, and all of it is rooted by that common bond of discovery, conservation, and of training young scientists. So it's important to note that both of these projects, Iceland and Vietnam, were funded through pilot opportunities provided by UIC, and they've allowed us to build international teams aimed at training students and fighting disease. But even after traveling the world, our best lead came from a strain that we collected right here in Lake Michigan. We discovered a bacterium that produces a molecule that selectively inhibits tuberculosis, and it's strongly active against many drug-resistant forms. And our team is now developing this lead in mouse models and using it to study how TB, a disease that infects a third of the world's population, is able to work. And I'm very proud to say that the majority of these discoveries were made by a diverse team of young scientists who are mostly in their 20s. And that's the real impact of our lab. It's training these kids to be both scientific and hopefully community leaders. So we've begun to spread our international philosophy locally as well. Through organizations such as Chicago Cares, we've teamed up with volunteers from all over the area to bring scientific opportunities directly to local students. Now, these are the amazing kids from the Marillac After School Program. We designed a curriculum that incorporates everything from the Great Lakes to outer space just to get these kids involved in science. Now, I'm not here simply because I worked hard. I'm here because I grew up with privilege, and with that privilege came opportunity. And we have the resources here at UIC to give kids that opportunity. And maybe it'll be a local kid who discovers the next TB drug from the Great Lakes. But for that to be so, we have to put them in a position to do that. Thank you.